We have never seen in our 14 and a half centuries a cult like ISIS. We've never seen anything like this.
These people have nothing to do with Islam. They have nothing to do with Islam. These people have nothing to do with this religion.
There will come other people. They will recite the Quran, but it will not pass their throats. This is an expression in Arabic. It means they will not comprehend it. It will be stuck within them. They will recite the Quran. Outwardly, they will appear to be Muslim, but they will leave the religion. Like an arrow goes through the prey. Suppose you're hunting a deer, a very sharp and good arrow. When you hunt it, it will come in from one side and leave the other side. So the Prophet ﷺ said, they will leave the religion like the arrow leaves its target. A good arrow will leave its target. And if I were alive when this group will come, then I shall destroy them like Allah destroyed the Qawm Ad. The people of Ad were all destroyed. I will take charge of destroying them. So in this hadith, we learn of a prediction. And this prediction is that there will be groups that will come in our ummah. There will be people that will come in our ummah. They are Muslims. We are not saying they are not Muslim. And they claim to be Muslim. And they recite the Quran. But they have nothing to do with the real teachings of our religion. And as Ibn Taymiyyah and others said, there are over 10 ahadith authentically narrated, predicting this group. No other group has been predicted with as many narrations as this one.
There's another troubling hadith that the Prophet ﷺ said, سَتَكُونُ فِتْنَةٌ فِي الشَّامِ أَوَّلُهَا لَعِبُ السُّبْيَانِ. It begins with children playing in Dar'a. And then he said that it'll just be after that one fitna after another. كُلُّمَا سَكَنَ فِتْنَةٌ هَاجَتْ فِتْنَةٌ أُخْرَى. Every time it calms down in one place, it starts up somewhere else. In this, إِذَا خَرَجَتْ رَايَةَ السُّودِ. If you see the black flags, فَإِنَّ أَوَّلَهَا فِتْنَةٌ. It begins with a fitna. وَوَسَطَهَا ضَلَالًا. And the midst of it is delusion, misguidance, error. وَأَخِرَهَا كُفْرٌ. And it ends with atheism. Because that's what's going to happen. People start losing their faith. What happened to the Europeans? They had World War I and II. It was enough for them. They don't believe in God anymore. They were a profoundly religious civilization. Look at all the churches they built. People can't take it. There's so much. Where is God? The question is not where is God, it's where are we? That's the question. He's not asking about what he did, but we're going to be asking about what we did. Why aren't we following the guidance of the Prophet ﷺ? And in this hadith that Makhul relates, he says, Mali wadi bani al-Abbas, because most of these they thought had to do with the Abbasids. But then he said, Shayyu ummati, they split my ummah. Wa albasuhum thiyab al-sawad. And they put black clothes on them. Albasuhum thiyab al-nar. May God put clothes of fire on them. These people are Khawarij. They're killing Muslims. They've every single criteria. And don't be fooled by their piety. Don't be fooled by their piety. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, عند صلاتهم تحقرون صلاتهم. When you see them pray, you'll consider your prayer insignificant. وعند صيامهم تحقرون صيامكم. But he said, يَقْرَؤُونَ الْقُرَانَ وَلَا يَتَجَاوِزْ حَنَاجِرُهُمْ. They'll recite the Quran, it won't go past their throats. The ulama said it means they won't understand it. They don't, because they don't have the tools. You can't understand the Quran without the tools. They won't understand it. And then he said, يَمْرُقُونَ مِنَ الدِّينَ. Sahih Bukhari. يَمْرُقُونَ مِنَ الدِّينَ كَمَا يَمْرُقُ السَّحْمُ مِنَ الرَّمِيَةِ. They will leave this religion like an arrow is shot out of a bow. And in a riwayah, in al-Bukhari, it says, يَخْرُجُ فِي أُمَّتِي. And then the Rawi says, مَا قَالَ مِنْهَا. There will come out amongst my ummah. And he didn't say from it, because they're not from him. These people are not from the Prophet ﷺ. They have nothing to do with the man who was sent as a mercy for all the world. These people are shayateen.
In another famous hadith, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there will be many differences in my ummah, but there will be one group that will come. That يقولون من خير قول البرية. They will say the best of all speech. يحسنون الكلام ويسيئون الفعل. They speak flowery speech, but their actions are very terrible. They shall recite the Quran, but it will not leave their throats. And they shall depart from their religion, just like the arrow departs from its prey. And they are the shirar al-khalq, they are the worst of the creation. Our Prophet ﷺ called this group the worst of the creation, even though right before he said, they recite the Quran. So these are not non-Muslims he's talking about. These are people who believe in the Quran and recite the Quran. And in this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, they call to the Book of Allah, but they have nothing to do with the Book of Allah. They call to the Sharia, but they have nothing to do with the Sharia. Pay attention to the words of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is predicting a group that is calling to the Book of Allah, to the Sharia, but he himself said they have nothing to do with the Sharia. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, those who fight them, those who do qital of them, are closer to the Book of Allah than they are. Meaning those who oppose these groups, they have more to do with the Sharia than this group that is calling to the Sharia. In another hadith, our Prophet ﷺ said that towards the end of times there will be a group of people, حُدَثَاءُ الْأَسْنَانِ سُفَهَاءُ الْأَحْلَامِ يَقُولُونَ مِنْ خَيْرِ قَوْلِ الْبَرِيَّةِ. حُدَثَاءُ الْأَسْنَانِ, young men, سُفَهَاءُ الْأَحْلَامِ, with foolish dreams. So this group is not going to be the elders of the ummah. They're not going to be the wise people with experience. They're not going to be people of knowledge. They are a young group of overzealous individuals. Hudatha'ul asnan, a bunch of kids, we would say in our modern term, young men, teenagers, early 20s. Hudatha'ul asnan. You don't become a leader at the age of 20 years old. You don't become a leader of a movement and you have barely experienced life. No, not just this, Sufaha'ul Ahlam. They have the most bizarre, the most ludicrous dreams, or not dreams here, but goals is the point. They have these goals that are totally unrealistic, and yet their speech is very flowery. يَقُولُونَ مِنْ خَيْرِ قَوْلِ الْبَرِيَّةِ. If you listen to them, you will be mesmerized because their speech sounds so good. And yet our Prophet ﷺ said that they will leave this religion. Again, the same analogy, like the arrow leaves its prey. And our Prophet ﷺ also said that تَحْقِرُونَ صَلَاتَكُمْ بِصَلَاتِهِمْ, that your salah, you will think it is nothing when you look at their salah. And your reciting of the Quran, you will think it is nothing when you look at them. And your religiosity, you will think it is nothing when you look at these people. And yet he said, they have nothing to do with me. They have nothing to do with me. And the final hadith will quote, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that these people are the worst of my ummah, and those who kill them or those who get rid of them are the best of my ummah. And the hadith is in Al-Bazar and other hadith books. So the Prophet ﷺ called them the worst of the ummah.
Now they're using these black flags because there's hadith about the black flags coming from Afghanistan towards the end of time. But they don't know that there's actually two different black flags. There's black flags of Bani Abbas, but then there's another group of black flags that we were warned against. These Yazidis have been living there for centuries. The Christians, this is a testimony to the beauty of our religion, that the Christian church of Syria and Iraq for centuries lived with their churches inviolable. They could worship God in their churches, and they weren't afraid of the Muslims. And now they're running, they're fleeing. Sayyidina Ali said, ثُمَّ يَظْهُرُ قَوْمٌ ضُعَفَاء لَا يُؤْبَأُ لَهُمْ. Then you will see these weak, insignificant people. لَا يُؤْبَأُ لَهُمْ. Insignificant people. Insignificant people. These are not notables. They have no learning. There's no scholars amongst them. Insignificant people. قُلُوبُهُمْ كَزُبْرَ الْحَدِيدِ. Their hearts are like pieces of iron. And in a riwayah, لا رأفة ولا رحمة على عدوهم. They have no mercy with their enemies. And the Prophet ﷺ said, من لا يرحم لا يرحم. They have hearts like iron. هم أصحاب الدولة. That's what he said. هم أصحاب الدولة. They're the people of Dawla. That's their name, Dawla. They call them Daesh in the Arab world. Dawla Islamiyah. they're the people of Dawla. That wasn't even a word the Arabs used other than just to revolve something. Tidka al-ayyam nudawiruha bainana. They didn't use it for state at that time. Hum ashab al-dawla. La yafuna bi'ahdin wala mithaq. They will not have any covenant. You can't trust them with anything that they say. يدعون إلى الحق وليسوا من أهله. They call to the truth, but they're not from the people of the truth. Why? Because in the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ, when Hudayfa, people were asking him about evil, Sahih Bukhari, Hudayfa ibn al-Yaman, the people were asking about good, he wanted to ask about shar, out of fear that he might see it. He said, يا رسول الله, كنا في جاهلية وشر, فجاءنا الله بهذا خير. We were in jahiliyyah and shar, and then God brought this good to us. Is there any bad after this good? He said, nah. And then he said, is there any good after that bad? He said, nah, wafihi dakhan. Yes, but it's going to be cloudy. It won't have the same purity. And he said, ma dakhanuhu ya Rasulullah. What's the cloudiness? He said, qawmun yahduna bighayri haddi. Ta'rifu minhum wa tunkiru. People will guide with other than my guidance. You will know some things and you'll reject other things. And then he said, is there evil after that good? He said, nah. دُعَاتٌ عَلَىٰ أَبْوَابَ النَّارِ مَنْ أَجَابُهُمْ قَذَفُوا فِيهِ. That those who, they're callers on the doors of the hell. If you answer them, if you respond to their call, you will be flung into the hell. Hudayfa said, صِفْهُمْ لَنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Describe them for us so we'll know them. هُمْ مِنْ جِلْدَتِنَا. They're Arabs. They're like us. مِنْ جِلْدَتِنَا. They look like us. يَتَكَلَّمُونَ بِأَلْسِنَتِنَا. They'll quote the Quran, they'll quote the Hadith. This is how the Prophet ﷺ described them. And then he said, ما كيف تأمرني يا رسول الله? What do you command me to do at that time? He said, إلزم جماعة المسلمين وإمامهم. Be with the jama'ah and the imam. وإن لم يكن لهم جماعة ولا إمام. What if there's no jama'ah and no imam? فاعتزل تلك الفرق كلها. وَلَوْ أَنْ تَعَضَّ بِأَصْرِ شَجَرَةٍ حَتَّى يُدْرِكِكَ الْمَوْتُ وَأَنْ تَعَلَى ذَلِكَ. Sahih Hadith. He said, avoid all those sects. Even if you have to cling to the root of a tree with your teeth until death comes to you. And you're on that. He didn't say, لابد أن تقيم الخلافة. هذا فرض كفاية. He didn't say you have to establish the خلافة. But these people, they don't study. They're Khawarij. And this media here is calling them Sunnis because they're killing Shia. They're not Sunnis. These aren't Sunnis. They're not Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. These are Ahl Iblis. Fariqan hada wa fariqan haqqa alayhim al-dalala. One group was guided and another group haqqa alayhim al-dalala. Thabata alayhim al-dalala. In the hadith then he says, asma'uhum al-kuna. Hudayfa said, the Prophet got up in a khutbah and he spoke the whole day. He said every single fitna that would happen until the end of time. He described the leaders, he told us their names, he told us what would happen, and he said some of us could remember and other us couldn't. Every single fitna. So don't think these things weren't mentioned. Asma'ahum al-kuna. Their names are Abu so-and-so and Abu so-and-so. They don't go by their real names. Asma'ahum al-kuna. When yusbatuhum al-qura, and they go back to towns, places. They don't go to tribes, because the Arabs, they go by tribes. These people know, they go by places. Al-Baghdadi, Al-Ambari, Al-Juwayshi, all these names of their towns that they're from. Al-Libi, Al-Musri, Al-Maghribi. They go back to places. This is what the Prophet ﷺ, because it has hukum al-rafa, and people can say it's a weak senate. Sounds pretty sound to me. وَشُعُورُهُمْ مِرْخَاتٌ كَشُعُورَ النِّسَاءِ. They have long hair, wearing it like women. Look at all the pictures of these guys with their long hair. Because it's not that the Prophet ﷺ didn't have long hair, but it's no longer fashionable in the Arab world. Arabs don't wear their hair long, so that's a sign that you know that. Their hair is long. حَتَّى يَخْتَلِفُوا فِيمَا بَيْنُهُمْ. They'll start fighting amongst each other. That's the nature.
We have never seen in our 14 and a half centuries a cult like ISIS. We've never seen anything like this. These movements are coming out of a particular social and political context. It is simply unfair and unjust to ignore the context of those regions and to ignore the political, the systematic and endemic violence that has been sustained by those people. I mean, Iraq and Syria have been at war, you know, internally and externally, the Syrian regime right now, you know, for the last 30 years, massacres upon massacres. From those, you know, mini Armageddons, from those bloodshed bats that are continuing over and over again, it's not surprising that you get this bizarre, apocalyptic, messianic, end of times movement that is responding in kind to what they've seen. The very fact that the Muslim world has not seen anything like this, and a simple example, a simple reality, Iraq and Syria had no radical and jihadist tendencies, you know, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, 7 years ago, 100 years ago. Iraq had never seen a suicide bombing in its 2,000 or 1,500 plus year of Islamic history until the 2004 American invasion. Now, you cannot ignore the political circumstances from within which this anger is coming. I'm not justifying, I am contextualizing. So it's so easy to blame the religion. It's so easy to say, oh, those Muslims. Go read a few books, listen to some lectures, ask an Iraqi, ask somebody who's been and seen there, and you will realize it's much more complicated than that.
This is a group of Muslims. The Khawarij were Muslims. ISIS is not Islam. It does not represent Islam. It doesn't mean that those people who are involved are not Muslims. To say, oh, they're all disbelievers, again, we've gone to our own extreme. We've gone to an extreme here. They are misguided Muslims. That much we can say, they're misguided Muslims. They do not represent what they're doing, what they're calling for, does not represent Islam. Because it goes against the teaching of the Quran and the Sunnah as it has been understood by the Ummah. When you take those teachings out of context and you create your own understanding, then of course you can produce anything.